Okay, good morning to all. I'm Mr. Khan. Welcome you in Mr. Khan Academy. Today I'm going to cover the 3.1.4, fourth part of series 3.1, under which I'm going to cover the methods for development of pneumatic system, in which we'll see the theoretical procedure how to develop a pneumatic system step by step. This series I divided the fourth part I divided into three parts. Okay, this is the part one. Before starting this video lecture, I request you all my viewers, you can check my previous two videos, that is 3.1.2 component of pneumatic system part 3. Again, component pneumatic I divided in three parts, the last part, and 3.3, the symbol standards in pneumatic. What are the various symbols are there, what is the significance, that all the symbols I covered in 3.1.3. The links of these two videos are available in this card icon, or you can check the all the links which is available on my channel on description box, or you can visit my channel by typing in your browser taskbar www.youtube.com/ Mr. that is MR Khan Academy and press enter. MR Khan Academy without space, full stop, underscore, continuously type MR Khan Academy and press enter. Then my channel page will be open. Then here you will get easy to follow video lectures based on mechatronics topics, which is segregate on introduction of mechatronics, that is series 1, electrical actuation system, that is series 2. Again, the various playlists available, the segregation of all the videos in which I cover the DC motor, stepper motor, AC induction motor and voice coil actuator. And just I recently started the series 3.1, which is based on the pneumatic. I cover the characteristics and application of pneumatic system, basic components of pneumatic system part 1, part 2, part 3 and standards and symbols. All the videos are available on my channel. You can check the video links on my channel. And one more thing, please hit the subscribe my channel, by which you will get the notification in whatever I am going to upload in future, and plus I will get the motivation to make a such video in future also. You can hit the subscribe button by clicking over here. If you are watching my video on desktop computer, by clicking over here also you can hit the subscribe button. If you are watching on mobile, for that purpose you can check in the description box, there the subscribe button is available below this video. You can click there also and you can subscribe my channel. Hit the like button agar aapko acha laga hoga to. Share this video with your friends also, those who need it. If you are having any doubt, any suggestion, feedback, please mention in comment box, and don't forget to hit the subscribe my channel. Let's see what are the topics I'm going to cover in this series. Till now I covered the 3.1.1, 3.1.2, as I said, in the three parts. All these video links are available in this card icon or description box. 3.1.3, symbols and standards. And today I'm going to start the 3.1.4, in which I'm just going to cover the development of pneumatic system, control chain, design of circuit diagram. Next part, part 2 of 3.1.4, I'm going to cover the circuit layout and designation of individual element and the life cycle of pneumatic system. Okay. Again, this video, the debate I divided in three parts. If you are required any notification in future regarding whenever I am going to upload this video, for that purpose you need to hit the subscribe button. Let's start the development pneumatic system. The solution to the control problem is worked out according to the system, with documentation playing an important role in communicating the final result. Then whatever the document parts are there while delivering pneumatic system, that play an important role for the solution of any control system. The circuit diagram should be drawn using the standard symbols and labeling, which I explained in the previous lecture, that is 3.1.4, available 3.1.3, sorry, which is available on my channel. Before starting this video, I recommend please go through that video. Compensated documentation is required, including the most of the following: function diagram, circuit diagram, description of operation of system, and technical data on the component. Additional with this, some supplementary documentation also required, for example, part list of all components, maintenance and faulty finding information, and spare part list. To develop a pneumatic system, there are two methods. One is the intuitive methods and second is a methodological method. Intuitive methods required more experience and great amount of time while drawing the complicated circuit. Based on the experience, we can create a development of pneumatic circuits also, that is called as intuitive methods. Second method is methodological method. Methodological method, a methodological design of the circuit diagram is according with the prescribed rule and structure. Okay, in which we recall some amount of methodological work and basic theoretical knowledge based on that. And this video lecture I'm going to focus on methodological design. Why? Because intuitive method is very coordinate with some single designer which having the more experience. They can only understand this, all those things. But suppose you are fresher and you want to understand the pneumatic circuit, then best way is a methodological design procedure. the previous more importance means the intuitive method is more importance given to use of least expensive hardware solution. Our aim is to do the cost cutting and use to get the output with the help of least expensive hardware solution. But now the aim while developing pneumatic circuit is to end up with the proper functioning and reliable operating control. Now it is industry wherever the pneumatic circuits are there, our aim is a proper functioning. The function, whatever the required task, should be executed properly and reliably operating control system. That is our aim. Therefore, now more importance is given to operational reliability and ease of maintenance by clear layout and documentation. Then that will be lead to us, based on these two statement, to use the methodological design procedure. Because in methodological design procedure, we are following all those things, the documentation, maintenance and operational reliability, everything is there, methodological design procedure. Because of that, in this video lecture, I am going to use this design, the methodological design procedure. Some disadvantages also there, methodological design procedure. Many cases, more components will be required as compared to intuitive methods. As said, intuitive method is based on a least expensive component we need to use. That is the aim of intuitive method. For methodological design procedure, we are using the more component is required, but additional material will be compensated by the time saving at the project stage and also later in the terms of maintenance. That time we can utilize that. Now, next part of this video lecture, that is control chain. The control chain is categorized representative of control system, from which amongst the other things and signal direction can be determined. That already explained in 3.1.1 characteristics and application of pneumatic system, that is a signal flow. The same manner, the control chain also there, in which we can get the flow of signal from bottom to top, in which energy supply is there. After the energy supply, we are sending the signal to input signal, then process signal, we are getting the output, and based on output, we are getting the execution. And these are the various component list which we can utilize for the energy supply. Energy supply, already I explained the standards and symbols, like compressor, reservoir, pressure regulating valve, service unit, these are the energy supply. Signal input is the push button valve, roller level valve, proximity switches, air barriers, signal processors, direction control valve, not head valve, pressure control, time sequence, signal output, again direction control valves, and command execution is pneumatic cylinders, actuators, we can say motor or linear or visual indicators. These are the control change. Then this part already explained in detail in 3.1.1 characteristics and application of pneumatic system. You can go through there, you can get in detail what exactly I am explaining, the signal flow in the control chain. Now, designing of the circuit diagram. The structure of circuit diagram should be related to the control chain. Whatever I explained previously, in the same manner, we need to design a circuit diagram. What I want to say that the level, whatever the levels are there, circuit should be based on this control chain. Whatever the levels are there, block, according to that, we need to design the circuit diagram. Simplified or detailed symbols may be used for the representation of circuit diagram. In the case of larger circuit diagram, the power supply part are shown on separate page of the drawing of the purpose of simplification. Now let's see, these are the signal flow, your control chain, these are the parts as a classification component, and these are the symbols we need to use according to level by level. This is the energy supply, we can use this symbol, energy input, that actuators, signal processing, we can use the non-return valve, yeah, dual pressure valve, signal flow output, again the, we can see the direction control valve, but is not mechanically we are operating, we are doing pneumatically, and last command execution like a motor or linear actuators. This part already I covered in 3.1, again you can check over there also. Now this circuit diagram, I am not going to explain in detail what exactly is there, the execution of this circuit diagram, how it execute. Just our aim in this circuit diagram is to, by pressing any one button from S1 or 1S2, the cylinder should be go forward direction, and when it reaches the maximum position, it should go in a reverse direction. That is our aim. Then this is 1S3. Then here, whatever the control chain as I explained previously, the supply energy, input, processing, control chain, and what, according to that they make this circuit one by one. This supply element, in which power supply is there, pressure supply is there, service unit is there, and supply actuator is there, button is there, we can say. Input element, three switches are there, 3x2, two position, three port, 3x2 manual operated, 3x2 manual operated, and 3x2 roller operated switches are there, non-idler. Processing element, that is the dual pressure valve. Control element, pneumatically operated 5x2, 5 port, 2 position, action control valve. And power component, it is actuator. Then based on that, we design by using the control chain, whichever I explained. We need to follow the control chain while designing the circuit. But how to develop the circuit by problem statement, that I am going to cover in next video. If a circuit diagram is represented in this systematic form, this is known as a circuit diagram. Irrespective of actual tubing connection of the installation, the circuit diagram structure is always the same. Means we need to follow the control chain, a signal flow, while designing the circuit diagram to representation. To understand more whatever explained, you can refer this book, but I am strongly referring a fundamental of pneumatic festo series, because whatever the content I taken for this video lecture, I refer this book only. You can refer this book to get the more knowledge. Thank you very much for watching this video. You can check my series 1 introduction to mechatronics and series 2 electrical actuation system. The links are available in the description box or this card icon, and don't hit to subscribe my channel to motivate me make a such video in future also. Hit like button if aapka acha laga hoga to. Share this video with your friends also, and if you are having any doubt, any comment, any suggestion, please mention in comment box, and don't forget to hit the subscribe my channel. Subscribe my channel to motivate me make such video in future also. Thank you very much. Bye bye. See you. Take care.